Hi everybody. Hello there. Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Hey guys, thanks a lot for connecting. Thanks a lot for joining. Una preguntita, ¿escuchan como un pitidito? Can you listen like a peep 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 or something?
No,
no, teacher.
Oh, so probably it's my computer. Se va a explotar. It's super weird. Se ve como un pip, 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 you know. Okay. So I'm going to figure out qué es lo que le está pasando. All right. So thanks
everybody. Ya trabajar la computadora.
I guess so. Yeah, I think so. No, but, you know, super weird. De repente es como pip, pip, pip. Like, como si fuera un carro. So I was like, what's going on? ¿Por qué escucho esto? Okay. But anyway.
Descanso quiere.
Probably, yeah. Probably it's just that. Hey, Ingrid. Hello, guys. Good evening. Gracias por conectarse. Thanks a lot. Yeah, I see most of you guys. Hey, Natalie. Me imagino que va en camino a casa, so be careful. I got Jocelyn, Norberto, Moses. I see a couple of you. So guys, give me just a second. Vamos a revisar asistencia really quick. Espero que hayan tenido un excelente día, right? I hope you just...
Good evening, teacher.
Hey, Danny. Good evening. Thanks for joining. So, solo espero que tengan un excelente día, you know, a nice Tuesday. Que haya sido un día muy productivo, all right? And we are going to... get started. Deme un segundito. Allow me just a second here. Let me check just your attendance para que podamos dar inicio to today's class. Okay, so, well, my first person is always Ana Delmi. So, Ana Delmi, ¿está por acá? Are you around? Ana? Okay, probably not. Brenda, are you around, Brenda? Okay, not yet. Brian, Sprang here?
Yes, I'm here.
Hey, Brian, good evening. Gracias por la confirmación. Danny, yes, right?
Hi, teacher.
Yes, very good. Danny's? Todavía no. Danny's is not here. Daisy, chicas, Daisy?
I'm here.
Thank you so much, Daisy. Giovanni, Giovanni, are you around? Not yet. Por ahí vi a Natalie. I think I saw Natalie some seconds ago. Okay, yeah, I think she's right there. Solo que quizás no nos escucha right now. Un segundito. Ingrid, think I saw Ingrid also. So, hey Ingrid, me imagino que está en camino, no worries. I got you there. Luego me da confirmación verbal, right? It's good. Jackie, I think I heard Jackie hace un momentito también.
Present, teacher.
Yes, thank you so much. Jesus, thank you, Ingrid. Jesus. ¿Está con nosotros? Are you with us? Creo que por ahí lo he comentado. Hey, thank you so much, Jesus. Me imagino que va en camino también, right? I imagine that you are still on your way. All right, thanks a lot. No se preocupen, no worries. Jocelyn?
Present.
Thanks a lot, miss. Norberto, Norbert.
Present.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Marvin, do we have Marvin here? Marvin, Marvin. No, I don't think I see Marvin. Maybe not. Miriam Claribel. Yes.
Present, miss. Hello.
I see you. Very good. Hello, miss. Good evening. Moses. Lo vi super temprano, Moses. I saw him very early. Good evening. Renee. Guys, ¿me escuchan? Can you hear me? Somebody
yes.
Dice que no me
yes.
Okay. Si se me corta or something, please me avisan to fix it. Sandra.
Pero su cámara se ve fea.
La cámara se ve pixeleada.
Sí.
Ok, entonces en mi internet. Deme un segundito, ya voy a conectarlo directo. Deme un segundito. Okay. Let me just make sure I got this. Okay. So Sandra me da confirmación cuando me escuche. Creería que no me escucha. Okay. Sandra Flores, Sandra, ¿está por acá?
Present, teacher.
Thanks a lot. Yarixa. Yarixa todavía no está por acá. Ok, let me see. Me faltan. Ya vi a René por ahí. Hello, René.
Hello.
Good evening. Hello, hello. Gracias por conectarse. Let me see. Creo que también Brenda. Yeah, so.
Yes, teacher present.
Thanks so much. Ana Delmi, no sé si ya nos acompaña. Also, I believe she doesn't. Okay. Okay, so I will go over attendance in some minutes. You know. Okay, super weird. Un segundito. Give me just a second. Okay. Okay, everybody. So thanks a lot. Gracias por conectarse. Thanks for joining and for being with us. Okay. Today we are going to have class number 12. So we are still in week number 3. And in a way, vamos a hablar un poquito sobre like present activities, future activities. Okay. Vamos a continuar el tema de ayer y vamos a hacer un pequeño, you know, cruce entre presente, you know, and continuous. Jesus, if you feel more comfortable, puede apagar la camarita un momento, you know, para que no vaya like super worried about it. Yo sé que está ahí, but you know, it makes us feel nervous. Bueno, al menos a mí. It makes me like feel really nervous because I mean, it's pretty scary que pueda tener un accidente. Yo sé que está ahí. Thanks a lot. For, you know, joining and connecting. So, okay. Well, guys, part of the things that we have for today are just present continuous, some conversations, some vocabulary, okay? But to get started, tengo una especie de trivia for you. Last time we played it, y me di cuenta que algunos son muy buenos, you know? Some of you are really good at trivias, okay? So we are going to play a trivia super, super quick, all right? So, deme un segundito. So this one is called answer the following questions, okay? No es tanto como we are not going to get points, we are not going to get, you know, anything, but just the satisfaction que tenemos general knowledge, right? That is just general content. So allow me a second and I'm gonna shoot the question. So of course you can activate your microphone, you share your ideas, no es necesario que lo escriban, pero nos pueden of course participar, right? You can participate with us. So question number one is a piece of cake. Está bien fácil. How many days? Uy, no, wait. No eran days. Hold on. Give me just a second. Hubo un error de dedo. Let me correct this super quick. Because that is not a day. So this is the word. Okay. Hold on. Uy. Okay, there you go. So question number one says, how many eggs are in a dozen? Guys, what is the answer? How many eggs are in a dozen?
It's 12, miss.
12. It's 12. Yes, it's 12. Whenever you say a dozen, hablamos de 12, right? Exactly. Very good. That's question number one. So guys, si tienen algo diferente, you know, it's just general knowledge. Let's go with the second. How many letters are in the alphabet? How many letters?
26, 25.
25?
25.
American alphabet. American alphabet. Okay.
It's 25 means 25.
25 and 26. Okay. So 25, 26.
26.
¿Alguien tiene a different answer? 25, 26, 27, 28. What do you think?
27.
27. Okay. So 25, 26. Or 27. In Spanish alphabet, tenemos más letras, right? We have ñ, I think we have double L, etc. But American alphabet has 26 letters. So it's only 26. If you get that correct, very good job. Nice. Now let's go with the next. How many zeros are in a million? How many zeros are in a million?
Six.
Six zeros. Okay, so six zeros. Okay. Yeah, that's very good. Exactly, six. Okay. Spell the word tonight. Any volunteer, guys? ¿Quién la quiere deletrear? Who wants to spell the word tonight?
T-O-N-I.
Yes.
Help,
help.
L-H-T.
G-H-T, exactly. So G-H-T. Very good job. Yes, Renee, exactly. Tonight. Now, guys, ooh, I make like a lot of a spelling thing. Sorry about that. Next question says, is Celine Dion, it says Dios, but it's Dion. Is Celine Dion from USA? Give me the answer. Yes or no?
Yes, she is me.
Okay, so Celine Dion is from USA. ¿Alguien tiene una respuesta diferente? Do you have a different answer?
She's not Dios, teacher.
No, no, no. Yeah, I was telling you guys. I mentioned, fue un error de dedo. So there is a spelling mistake. But it's Celine Dion. Yeah, so is Celine Dion from USA? What would you say? Yes or no? Is she from USA? Would you say yes?
I don't know.
No.
What is the country?
United States?
Actually, no. Canada. But it's close. Canada. Celine Dion is from Canada. So she speaks French and English. Mm-hmm. So she's from Canada. Okay. Next question. Who sings the song Iris? Who sings the song Iris?
Go-Go Dolls, me.
Go-Go Dolls, yes, very good. That's a beautiful song.
I like song, me.
That's a beautiful song, guys. ¿La han escuchado? Yeah. Have you heard that song, Iris?
No.
No?
Yes, in the movie.
In the movie, exactly. So, either way, si nunca la han escuchado, no worries. Se las recomiendo. Go listen to it. Y probablemente ya la han escuchado, but you don't know the name. So this is a very famous song. Okay. Next question. Who is the president of USA? This is very easy.
Joe Biden.
Okay. Biden. Exactly. Biden. Very good. And the next one. How many states are in USA? How many states?
53.
55. 50. Okay. Actually, yeah, it's considered to be 50. 50. And this is the last question for me. Name five American bands. So, guys, can you tell me the name of five bands in USA? Five American bands? Music bands, of course. Music bands.
Metallica.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Metallica. That's one. Guys, Guns N' Roses, too. Okay.
Slipknot.
Slipknot. All right. Is that American? I'm not sure.
Linkin Park.
Linkin Park. Okay, four. No, no sé si Slipknot is American. Probably no. Yes.
No, and? Yo creo que son alemanes. ¿No?
Slipknot.
No.
I'm not sure. To be honest with you.
Danny sabe.
Yeah, but Danny no ha venido, es cierto. Danny's not here yet. No, he's not here yet. Guns N' Roses, yes, nos falta una. Let's say Slipknot. Okay, yeah. Luego averiguamos. And?
Kiss.
Kiss, okay. Isn't it British? Creo que es británica. Yeah. I think it's British, yeah. But I'm not sure. Oh, yes, Slipknot is American. Yes, that's an American band. Backstreet Boys. Backstreet Boys.
Yo no lo dije para no irme tan vieja.
Y con lo que salía.
But that was a good band. Especially, creo que la mayoría somos, andamos en la misma edad. So I guess everybody listened to Backstreet Boys, right? And we kind of feel identified with the music. Very good job, guys. What is it?
Goodbye.
René dice que las bailaba, las de Backstreet Boys.
Backstreet. Oh, tenían coreografías, I think. They had choreographies. Uh-huh. René las bailaba. Okay. Okay, so probably one day nos puede mostrar la coreografía of any of those songs. I just remember Britney Spears and oops, I did it again. So that's the only one. Mm-hmm. But yes, very good job, guys. That was nice, well played, and very good knowledge. So muy buen conocimiento de cultura general, okay? Now let's get started with one of the topics that we got for today. That is, oh, Bon Jovi, Ingrid said, okay. Well, Bon Jovi is the name of the person, si no me equivoco, is the name of the singer, and he had a band, pero no estoy seguro. Oh, I remember this. What is the name of the band? The, oh my God, the Michael Jackson? Michael Jackson tenía una banda when he was young.
Jackson 5.
Jackson 5, Jackson exactly. 5. That's an American band, yes. All right. So let's move on, okay, and let's take a look at part of the activities that we got for today. So allow me 1 second, y les comparto here our first conversation of the night, okay? So nuestro objetivo de ahora is describe ongoing activities accurately and regular activities at work. Vamos a hacer una pequeña mezcla de dos cosas, lo que está pasando y rutinas, okay? Now, to get started, we have a little conversation, okay, that is really easy, I would say. So, help me read it, guys. So, voy a leer la primera parte y ustedes me ayudan a leer el resto. I got, good afternoon, Raúl. What are you doing right now? So, Danny, can you please continue?
Good afternoon, Ryan. Well, I am planning a video conference.
Very good. Brian, can you please continue?
Perdón, que no estaba poniendo atención porque estaba poniendo el ventilador.
No, it's okay. Ayúdame a leer este pedacito, please. Help me read this part. Oh. Here, where the mouse is.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. Good afternoon. I am Raúl or Ryan.
Abajito, en la tercera interacción, donde está el cursor, please. Donde dice, oh, the conference.
Oh, the conference with the new team in San Salvador. What is your team doing right now?
Thank you very much. Ana, please, can you continue with the part of Raúl?
Yes, it is. They are getting ready for the conference in the meeting room.
Thank you very much. Bless you guys. Daisy, please, can you help me read the part of Ryan?
I see
What time do you usually get to your workplace? What's the first thing you do?
Okay, thank you very much. And Giovanni, please, can you help me read this part? Giovanni, are you around? Maybe not. Elizabeth?
Hola.
Hello, Miss. Me ayuda a leer esta parte, please. Can you help me read this part? ¿Dónde está el cursor?
Sí, ahorita voy.
Thank you very much.
I usually arrive at
6:30.
I usually arrive at 6:30
a.m.
They first thing.
Yep.
I do is to check my email.
Okay.
Check my email. And you.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay. And the last part is Ryan right there. Claribel, please, can you help me read the last part of Ryan?
Okay, miss. Well, I arrive at 7 or 7:30. It depends on traffic. My first activity is to pick up the letters.
Thank you very much. Okay, exactly. So we have here a couple of very important questions. The first one is, what are you doing? And the person says, I am planning a video conference. What is our team doing? They are getting ready for the conference. And then we have this question. That is, what is the first thing you do? Como la rutina, right? ¿Qué es lo que todos los días haces? What is the first thing you do? So I usually arrive at 6:30. Yeah, and the first thing I do is to check my email. So, vamos a revisar estas tres preguntas because they are really important. So, let me write them down right here. So, question number one is, what are you doing? Okay. The other one is, what is your team doing? Right? And the last one is, what is the first thing you do when you arrive? When you arrive to work. Okay, so tres preguntas, different questions, different answers, okay? Y me piden diferente tipo de información. So what are you doing? Yesterday vimos que para hablar de lo que estamos haciendo ahorita, we say something like I am and then ing. I am reading, I am paying attention, I am paying, I am listening. What is your team doing? Well, ya son las 8, ellos ya están viendo televisión. Están descansando. Yeah, so they are resting right now. They are taking a shower right now. Or they are having dinner with their families, okay? Now, eso cambia. What is the first thing you do when you arrive to work? Porque ya es una rutina. So I can say, I usually, yeah, I always... I never, I, ¿qué otras palabras puedo utilizar para hablar de frecuencia? Do you remember? Usually, always, often. Never, often,
sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yes, etc.
Rarely,
exactly. So yo puedo utilizar cualquiera de estas palabras para hablar, you know, con qué frecuencia yo llego temprano. Arrive early. So, I always arrive early. I often arrive early. I never arrive early. Pero no creo que sea su caso. I don't think so. And then we say like, okay. And the first thing I do, and the first thing I do is, the first thing I do is to. So, ¿qué es lo que hacen? Well, in my case, the first thing I do es loguearme. Is to log in my computer. Okay, or the first thing I do is poner el dedo. ¿Cómo se le llama eso? Marcar, okay? So I clock in, all right? Or the first thing I do is, I don't know, voy a desayunar. I have breakfast. Or I don't know. Todos tenemos una rutina diferente, okay? So help me with these questions. La primera yo sé que puede sonar como repetitiva, pero every single day we are doing something different, okay? So not necessarily is the same as yesterday. What are you doing? For example, ahorita estoy escuchando el pitido que les mencioné de mi computadora, que ya va a estallar, you know? So like, I am listening to this beep sound, all right? Or, well, estoy pensando en qué voy a hacer de cena. I am thinking about what I'm gonna eat for dinner, all right? Dennis, hello, good evening. Gracias por acompañarnos. Thanks a lot. Hello, hello. And then you go with the others. What is your team doing? ¿Qué están haciendo los compañeros de trabajo, right? And the last one, what is the first thing you do when you arrive to work? So les doy dos minutitos para que pensemos un poco en la respuesta. Las pueden escribir. You can also write them down. Okay, para que ya estemos súper listos. Ingrid, hello, good evening. Gracias por conectarse. Thanks a lot. Espero que ya haya llegado a su trabajo. Also, vi por ahí ya Jesus. So, hello, Jesus. I'm glad que ya llegó and you're sound and safe.
Teacher.
Hello.
I talked to you about that I'm doing. I'm working.
Do you have an emergency? I believe, right?
Yes. I have a cat with.
I'm watching
my scissors, my instrumental, and I think my team all are resting. My team, resting.
You are working.
But I'm working.
Are you about to open up the cat?
I take out it.
I
of cat and go out because
I don't like cats.
He was bite by a dog. Entonces,
you can use this word. Oh, but it's tan brutal. So I am extracting an eye. Yeah, so I am taking out an eye. Wow, but that's so heavy, you know. Yes.
yes, taking out an eye.
Is it a surgery? Es como una cirugía.
Yes, it's a surgery.
Okay.
So. With anesthesia general anesthesia.
Okay, so you can also say that, you know, I'm performing a surgery with anesthesia.
I'm performing a surgery with anesthesia.
Mm-hmm. Anesthesia.
Performing is the performance.
Yeah, but in this case, es como estoy llevando a cabo. Es como estoy haciendo, estoy realizando. So I'm performing a surgery, yes.
Yo digo, I'm doing a surgery, es incorrecto.
No, está bien, pero performing es como un poco más técnico, we can say.
So I'm doing performing a surgery. I'm
performing. Mm-hmm. Because in your case, de hecho, son performances. Es como algo de realizar, de, you know. So that's called a performance. Mm-hmm. So I'm performing.
Wow. Okay.
The best of luck. Espero que el gatito salga bien de eso, you know. And no worries. Thanks a lot. Gracias por igual.
But I pay attention. I'm working. Estoy trabajando mejor porque estoy haciendo otras cosas y sí estoy poniendo atención y se me quedan las cosas.
Wow, you're multitasking. Okay, good. That's all right then. Good to hear. Actually, yes, guys. Hay varias formas de aprender. So it's very important que identifiquemos también cómo aprendemos más fácil, right? One of them es solo oyendo, yeah? So there are people que hoy escucha y se le queda mejor. Some others prefieren leerlo o ver dibujos, you know, and it's better. And as Idalia said, hay otras personas que necesitamos hacer otras actividades, you know, y nuestro cerebro como si las combinara. So that's very important, saber de qué forma aprendemos mejor. So, guys, ya tenemos la respuesta. Do you have the answer? Do you need more time? 1 minute, 2 minutes? ¿Quién está listo? Who is ready with the answers? ¿Quién está listo, chicos? Who is ready? Give me some confirmation, please. Like, teacher, necesito una hora. I need an hour. Or like, I'm ready. So give me, tell me something.
I need 5 minutes, teacher.
I can give you 2. So podemos negociar. We can negotiate that part. Okay, so 1, I'll give you 2 minutes. That's okay.
Two minutes.
No, 2 is fine. I'll give you 2. Guys, in the meantime, denme un segundito. Voy a ver si mejora mi cámara. Hold on, hold on.
Que hey, pasen la copia, pues ahorita no está la teacher.
Hi, Dani.
Hi. Hi, co-workers.
Very good.
Hi, Dani. Hi, Dani.
Hey, hi.
Hi, hi, Brian.
What are you doing?
I am
learning English.
¿A qué se refiere cuando es what is your team doing? Como equipo de trabajo. Okay.
Think. Oh. What? Team doing.
Ah. Uh-huh.
Tu compañía. Ajá, uh-huh, tu compañeros o como equipo, ¿verdad?
¿Qué así es que hace en tu equipo de trabajo?
El team bolos.
O qué hace en tu equipo, ¿cómo sería?
No, ¿qué hace tu equipo?
Descontar.
Zap.
Wow. ¿Quién ha respondido ese que nos pase la copia, man? What is your team doing, co-worker?
Mi Big Big. Mi Big Big, ¿qué pusiste, mi Big Big?
Haciéndole estoy ahorita. My co-worker are working right now.
Mi co-worker.
Póngale cero.
What is co-worker, compañero?
Compañero, yes, yeah, compañeros de trabajo.
Hey guys, I'm back. But I believe it is my
teacher,
internet.
Teacher, necesitamos de su ayuda.
Dígame, tell me.
Con las preguntas, como volver. Casi no, bueno, en mi caso, sí me puede volver a explicar más, digamos, esas preguntas.
Yes,
la segunda.
Absolutely, no problem. Dime 1 second.
Yes, teacher, I don't, ¿cómo se dice?
Guys, but me escuchan claro. Can you hear me like super clear?
Yeah.
Me estoy quebrando.
Super clear.
Am I breaking?
Super clear.
Super clear. Yes.
Excellent.
So probably it is my camera. Okay.
No, super clear.
Yeah, lo que pasa es que mi cámara se ve como pixeleado.
No.
Los audífonos le hacen falta, teacher.
Yo no lo veo pixeleado.
No.
Ah, okay.
Entonces, ahorita no, porque está la pantalla chiquita.
That's a good point. Ya intenté conectarme directo, but yo sí me veo un poquito pixeleado. All right. So, okay, in the first part, dice, what are you doing, right? So, es como ahorita, en estos momentos, what are you doing? So, here, lo que ustedes tienen es este pedacito that says, I am, más el ING de lo que vimos ayer. So, I am reading, I am speaking, I am paying attention. Por ejemplo, nos decía Natalie, I am, you know, working, okay? Porque estaba con un paciente, right? So, she had a patient. Imagínense, por ejemplo, que Jesus todavía fuera en la moto. So he could definitely say, I am riding a motorcycle. And it's okay. Porque es como en este momento, in this very moment, ¿qué están haciendo? Okay. So,
teacher.
Yes.
En el ejemplo que acaba de dar, entonces yo tendría que decir, what is your team doing? Yo diría, they are studying in the video conference.
Oh, yes, of course, of course. Yeah. Si tiene al otro miembro de su trabajo, right? De su equipo here o en otro lugar, pero estudiando, of course, you can say, oh, they are having classes. They are studying. They are learning English. O tal vez alguno de sus compañeros de trabajo todavía está trabajando. So, oh, some of them, okay, alguno de ellos, some of them are working. Yeah. Entonces es como, ¿qué están haciendo ellos? What are they doing right now? The next one is more specific, let's say. It says like, what is the first thing you do when you arrive to work? So, cuando usted llega a su trabajo, what is the first thing you do? ¿Qué es lo primerito? What is the first activity you do, guys? Yeah. So, well, puede ser.
I drink a coffee.
I drink coffee. Okay, so I drink coffee. O voy a buscar qué comer. I go and get breakfast.
I go to the bathroom, teacher.
Okay, no more details. That's okay. That's good to know. Or the first thing I do is I sanitize everything. So yo sanitizo, I clean, you know. Entonces puede que sea diferente, you know. It could be different. So like this, here podemos agregarle con qué frecuencia. I usually do this. I always go for coffee. I normally go to the cafeteria to get breakfast. Okay. Yes, Natalie.
Cuando yo voy a. Bueno, ahorita que quiero responder. What is the first thing to you do when you arrive to work? En este caso no va con ING, ¿verdad? Porque, por ejemplo. First thing that I do when I arrive to work is check my emails.
Exactly. Ya no es con ING. Yes, that's a very good point. Yeah, exactly. Ya no utilizamos ING. Y, you know, after this activity, vamos a ver como cuál es la diferencia. What's the main difference?
Porque ahí no se pone, teacher.
Ya lo vamos a ver. We are going to check that in a little while. Porque es un poquito más de gramática, you know. But in the meantime, quiero que nos familiaricemos con el uso, you know, más que la parte gramatical. But ya se los voy a explicar, no worries. Pero no va ING. We don't use ING in this one. Guys, ¿tienen las respuestas? Do you have the answers for these? Más o menos, a little bit, kind of. In process.
A little bit.
No worries. Yes. That's okay. In the meantime, van a escuchar a los compañeros que tienen otras ideas, you know, y ustedes van a agregar las propias. So, allow me just a minute. Voy a crear grupos ahorita because I want you to, as I said yesterday, este es un tema para familiarizarse right now, okay? So let's get familiar with the topic. Compartamos the answers to your questions. Y luego venimos y vamos a comparar, you know, and to clarify some other things. So, tienen 5 minutitos. You have 5 minutes. Go and then come back. Let's go, everybody.
Le voy a compartir mi pack ahí.
El pack.
Dame, ahí están las preguntas.
Okay, thank you.
¿Quién va a comenzar? Les voy a preguntar yo. What are you doing, Michael Walker?
I am learning. Class.
Sorry. Tranqui, relax.
Dale, Brian.
Oye, no quieren, pero vaya. Yo, I am learning English. Y I am watching TV. Hi, good evening. Hi, good evening. ¿No me escuchan?
Yes.
¿Qué pasa?
I am listening to you. I am thinking I don't work tomorrow.
Okay. What is the first thing you do when you are ready to work? Sandra.
I leave a call to my boss.
Ah, okay. Norberto. I usually to the bathroom porque voy de lejos de mi casa, pues sí, cuando llego lo primero es a lavarme las manos y todo. No crean que solo ahí paso todo el día.
No sabemos.
Brian.
I usually clean my office. I always going to breakfast with my friends, with my co-worker, Diana. I don't know, I check my emails, I report, I check the photography, the accident photography.
Okay. Norberto?
Hello, la primera dice, what are you doing? I am listening to Miss Julia's class. Number two, what is your team doing? Una preguntita, esa palabra de resting, ¿qué significa?
Descansar.
Ah, ok. Bueno, entonces yo la cambié y they are with your family, what's TV?
Oh, okay.
And number three, what is the first thing you do when you are ready to work? I sometimes read early, and the first thing I do is turn off the computer and the AT. ¿Verdad que si se dice aire acondicionado, AT? I don't remember.
Yes.
AT, no me recuerdo cuáles son las palabras. O AC, no me recuerdo.
AC.
AC.
Abreviado AC.
AC, ok.
AC, creo que es.
Only that, guys. Solamente eso.
Ok, very good.
Ok, mire. Next, Giovanni.
Ok. The first is, what are you doing? I am watching my cell phone and my computer. I am studying English and I am drinking coffee. The second is, what is your team doing? Some are sleeping and others are watching TV, and the third is I usually disinfect my body and later I turn on my computer and I start to work.
Excelente.
Sí.
Protocol.
Y daría sanitizer. Más.
Can you make me the question, please? And I will answer. Nanis.
Oh, you.
Yeah, can you make me the questions?
Okay.
No las tiene escritas, entonces.
Oh.
Entonces, este.
Adal... you are gone? Or, no, what?
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Okay. Right now, I'm watching to you. Yeah,
okay.
I'm paying attention right now. After with I performing, I will performance the surgery. But right now I'm paying attention. I am practicing pronunciation, and I am answering your questions.
Okay.
Okay.
The second is, what is your team doing?
The second thing that I am doing right now, right? That sería performing the surgery. Oh, preparing the. Instrumental for performance the surgery.
Yes, for multi-light. Oh, yes.
Yes. Yes. Pobre gatito, pero a él le tocó.
Okay.
The cat is coming now. The cat is in traffic right now with my.
College.
I will make the surgery with college. My college is coming to here right now, but he is in traffic.
Oh, responsible of what sería dueño?
To wake up well. Como para levantarme bien, va. Estoy todavía medio dormido.
Okay. In you English.
Eso, eso estoy pensando ahorita. Okay. I am no, ya les digo poco. Entonces eso estoy escribiendo ahorita.
Okay. Okay. Estaría bien. Entonces, I am always. Sí.
En la última. I always, nada más.
Solo I always.
Ajá, yo siempre. Y ahí lo demás. Porque yo puse I usually. O sea, yo usualmente.
Ajá. Always. Often. Okay. Usually sanitize the como se dice en las vitrinas.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Vitrinas.
Oh, okay.
Como se dice el cambio de caja, the change, Pichang, ¿verdad?
So coming with Jocelyn, probablemente podríamos usar la palabra shelf, right? Okay. Ingrid, I'm sorry, ¿cuál era la palabra? What was the word?
Para decir preparo el cambio de caja, sería prepare the chunk, o ¿cómo se pronuncia eso?
Change.
Cambio como vuelto, ¿verdad?
Chain, ajá, cambiar, chain. Ah, esa es la palabra
como que vuelto.
Ajá, exacto.
Como doy el vuelto, el cambio de caja.
Es que, ah, o es cierre, pero...
No, es que lo que quería explicar era preparo, o sea, nomás llegar yo a mi trabajo, enciendo la computadora y preparo el cambio de caja, o sea, no mi fondo, de lo que voy a preparar en el día.
Mm, what is that? Okay, hold on, let me get
it. Okay, o sea, es como el conteo de lo que tenés en el momento para saber cómo, qué cantidad vas a cuadrar.
No, o sea, yo saco mi fondo, la preparo ya para cuando yo empiece a cobrar, yo ya tengo mi caja. O sea,
para tener vuelto. Ya,
ajá, vuelto, exacto, para poder.
Para poder devolver, ¿verdad?
Exacto.
Okay.
Eso es lo que hago. Pero entonces, chain, ¿verdad?
Pero ¿cómo se llama? In Spanish, cambio de caja.
El cambio de caja. Es como, para darlo. O sea,
entiendo yo.
¿Mande?
Es como un fondo de inicio, ¿verdad? Que le dan
ajá,
todos los días.
Eso, exacto. O sea, yo tengo mi fondo de todos los días. O sea,
como,
yo
digamos que todo. Como su caja de vuelto, su caja chica in some places.
Exacto, eso. Entonces quizás será mejor que le pusiera caja chica. Preparo mi caja chica.
No, my cash desk. Cash desk.
O cashback. No,
you can, yeah, no. I would say you can use the word cash desk. I prepare my cash desk. My cash desk. Esa podría ser una forma. This can be a way.
Preparo my cash desk. Y en español, ¿cómo se me preparo mi caja?
Yeah, because I don't see... No es el cierre de caja.
No, no es el cierre, o sea, es
como la apertura.
Es algo así, o sea, yo preparo las monedas que yo voy a empezar a dar cuando yo abro caja. Es como ordenar las monedas, ¿verdad? Es como ordenar lo que yo voy a empezar a cambiar cuando ya el cliente llega a pagar.
Yes, I got it. Solo estoy buscando una forma de decir something similar. Because, yeah, podemos decir my cash desk.
Preparo my cash desk.
Yeah, that is a cash desk.
Preparo mi cambio de caja.
I would use that one. Yes, tell me.
Es medio complicado eso.
Yes, I know. Tell me, Marvin.
Yo, por ejemplo, lo primero es I always check my folder because I have to complete the forms.
Okay. At the beginning.
Sí.
So that is the first activity to do. So at the beginning. Okay. Okay, guys, what do you do? ¿Cuál es lo primero que hacen? So in the case of Ingrid, I heard that she prepares, like she gets ready. She prepares all the money that she needs to start the shift. Okay. What about you? What do you do? Jocelyn, what is the first activity you do?
I always is open the work. Then
okay. You open the offices, right? You open the offices. Usando las llaves, you get the keys.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. I am. No, no I am. I usually sanitize the shelves.
Okay.
And the encender teacher of the printer.
Oh. Yeah, and turn on the printer. Oh. Turn on. Yes, I'm gonna write it there. because this is turned on and I turn on the printer. Okay. That sounds okay. That sounds very good. Elizabeth, no le he escuchado. I haven't heard you. Hey, girl.
Hola, teacher.
Hello, miss. What is the first activity you do? ¿Qué es lo primero que hace, miss? What is the first activity you do?
¿Qué es lo primero que hago?
Yep.
Le diré.
Bless you.
They feel thing and do when I get
arrive. Okay.
Is to clean my work area.
Okay, very nice. So you clean your work area. Okay. Yeah, so you sanitize, you clean. All right. So she checks her money. Marvin checks the folders. And Moises, what about you? What is the first thing you do? You told me. ¿Qué era lo primero? What is the first thing you do?
I usually I clean the desk. Turn on the computer.
Okay.
I usually also have breakfast in the office.
Okay, okay. Yeah, that's okay. Well, now I guess it's different because algunos ya empezaron a trabajar de casa, I believe. ¿Alguno de ustedes está trabajando desde la casa? Are you working from home? No.
Never.
Oh, never, really? Okay. Never mind, no he dicho nada entonces. Okay, everybody, so vamos a regresar. Let's go back, please. Let's go back. See you in a second. Hello, Giovanni, and welcome back. Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for coming back.
Okay. I'll be here.
Yes, I know, I know. You're right here. I saw you like some seconds ago. So espero está todo bien. Ya le iba a preguntar a su hermano, you know. I was about to ask your brother. Okay, guys, so vamos a esperar unos segundos. Meanwhile, todos regresan, everybody's back. And these guys can share some ideas with us. So in the meantime, the first question que íbamos a revisar was, what are you doing? So what are you doing, guys?
I am in a virtual meeting to learn English.
You are in a virtual meeting to learn English. Very nice. Mm-hmm. I like that. Okay. Anybody else? What are you doing, guys?
I am listening to the teacher.
You're listening to the teacher. Okay. Jackie, what are you doing?
I am studying English.
Okay.
I am drinking water.
Okay.
I am listening music. Nice. I am watching the computer.
Oh my God, you're Ooh. Multitasking. She's doing a lot of activities at the same time. Very good. Guys, what are you doing? Ya no me pueden repetir. I am nada de inglés, please. So what are you doing?
I am cleaning my glass.
I am?
Cleaning my
Oh, glass. You're cleaning your glasses. Okay, nice. That's okay. Give me more, give me more, give me ideas. Nada de inglés. You cannot repeat English at all. Tell me.
I am listening to my co-worker.
You're listening to your co-workers. Okay. Whom? René and...
I watching my computer and I looking for information about the English.
Okay, so you're looking for information, yeah. Checking on the computer. Nice. Yeah, what about the rest? So, no pueden repetir, you cannot repeat what your classmates have said. So, tell me, what are you doing? For example, Danny is shaking the pen or the pencil, okay? So, like, tell me, guys, what are you doing? Cualquier dato, it's okay. Por ejemplo, si están acostados ya en la cama, me pueden decir, teacher, yo estoy recostada en la cama, and it's okay. Estoy sentado. You can do that in present continuous. O estoy parado. I mean, you can tell me like a lot of things. So tell me, what are you doing?
I am watching my daughter.
Oh, okay. Are you taking care of your daughter?
Yes.
Like, como cuidándola? Are you taking care of your daughter right now?
Viendo qué hace.
Uh-huh, like checking on her.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so we can, I am taking care of. So, es como estoy cuidando. I am taking care of my daughter. Okay, nice.
I am taking care of my daughter.
Yes, I'm taking care. Como le estoy a cargo de, la estoy cuidando. Yes. Norberto, what are you doing?
I am eating.
Oh, I'm sorry, Brenda, can you repeat?
I am eating. Estoy comiendo.
Oh, okay. Are you having dinner right now?
Yes.
Okay, enjoy it. That's all right. Enjoy it. Yeah. So, Norbert, what are you doing, Norbert?
I am drinking coffee. I am checking my smell.
Okay.
I am writing in my notebook.
Okay. Are you drinking coffee right now? Really?
Yeah.
Can you sleep after that? Yes, you can. ¿Puede dormir después? Can you sleep after that?
Yes, yes. Es la costumbre.
Okay, okay. My admiration, you know. Because otherwise, yo llevo hasta las 5 de la mañana and I cannot sleep at all. All right. Ana, tell me, what are you doing?
Que le enseñe la semita, teacher.
Y también, are you having semita?
No, teacher.
Only coffee?
No, only coffee.
Only coffee today? No, he's not having semita. So, Ana, tell me, what are you doing?
I am sending message.
Okay.
Message drinking water.
All right, that sounds very good. Actually, hay una palabrita here that I want to introduce ahora que escuché a Brenda, you know, y yo sé que algunas veces estamos como un poco sick. Okay, esta actividad cuando tenemos alergia, we call it like this. Eso se llama sneeze, okay?
Sneeze.
So, yeah, so Brenda is sneezing. So le agregamos ing and no what? No e. So this is estornudar, okay? I'm sneezing, okay. Yeah? Also, for example, yesterday, yo tenía mucha alergia. I had allergies yesterday. And I was like, okay? So this activity is called cough, okay? Cough. De toser, cough.
Oh.
So sneeze is when you may like chew. And cough is like, okay? Mm. So we got these two words, que... Guárdenla en su bolsa, right? Because it's going to be part of your vocabulary. Sneezing, okay, estornudar, and coughing, de toser, exactly, so coughing. Yes.
Okay.
I have a cough, exacto, yo tengo tos, I have a cough, pero sneeze es la actividad, entonces you can say, I am sneezing, estoy estornudando, or she is sneezing, de estornudar, yes. Okay, everybody. So now let's take a look at the following part. Revisamos entonces ahora sí la parte gramatical, little by little. We use present continuous to talk about arrangements for events at a time later than now. So ayer mencionábamos que era de hecho para dos cosas. La primera es como para ahorita y la segunda es algo que ya estamos seguros de hacer, ¿ok? So, we have the structure, subject, I, verb to be, I am, and then el ing que acá le han llamado gerundio. Pero no se preocupen, es el mismo ing. I am reading, I am sneezing, I am coughing, ¿ok? So, all of those activities son precisamente para utilizarlas con present continuous. So, veamos entonces algunas de estas palabritas. ¿Cuál es lo que va a ser diferente ahorita? Vamos a trabajar con futuro. Vamos a agregarle la palabra tomorrow. So, es lo mismo, pero yo le agrego tomorrow para indicar que la actividad va a ser mañana, la próxima semana, el próximo año, pero estoy segura que va a pasar, ¿ok? So, Marvin, please, can you be so kind y me ayudar a leer los ejemplos? Can you help me read these examples?
Desde la parte que dice...
What time? Desde acá, donde está AA y BB.
B.
AA and BB.
Ok. What time is Maria interviewing we the people? Así sería.
Interviewing, yes.
Interviewing the people.
Yes, y la respuesta es...
she's interviewing them at 5 p.m.
Exactly, very good. Okay, la segunda, okay. Please, the second.
I am reading the report next week. Nice. And I am starting seeing it as soon as you finish.
Very good, thanks a lot. So, what time is Maria interviewing the people? She's interviewing, los va a entrevistar. She is interviewing them at 5. So, es como decir va a o voy a, ¿ok? Pero yo estoy totalmente segura que esto... I am writing the report next week. Si se fijan, dice I am writing, pero no es ahorita, ¿ok? Es para la próxima semana. I am writing the report next week. I am sending it as soon as you finish. So, tan pronto como tú lo tengas, yo lo envío, ¿ok? Yo lo voy a enviar. So, pretty much, si lo quieren traducir, sería un voy a, ¿ok? Voy a comer, I am eating, voy a visitar, I am visiting. Y si quiero decir voy a, I don't know, voy a ir a la playa, ¿cómo lo dirían?
I am going to beach.
Exactly.
To the beach.
I am going to the beach. Es voy a tener una reunión.
I am going to the meeting.
I am going to a meeting.
I have a meeting.
To the meeting.
Pero como le tengo que agregar ing al verbo, I am
going to the meeting the next week.
Alguien utilizó have. ¿Cómo podría decirlo con have?
I am having a meeting.
I am having a meeting, exactly. I am going to a meeting. I am having a meeting. Very good. Si quiero decir, oh, voy a ir a una entrevista, how can I say that?
I am going to interview.
I am going to an interview, exactly. So pretty much es futuro, okay? Solo que le agregamos la palabra next week para ser bien específica. Or tomorrow, o en qué momento lo vamos a hacer, como at 5 p.m. So, revisamos este ejercicio, number 4, and es la página 30, if you want to check your material, and it says, unscramble the following words to create sentences. ¿Cuál es la forma más fácil de hacerlo? Sigamos la estructura de arriba. Busquemos cuál es el sujeto, el verbo to be, y luego ing. Cuando tengamos esos elementos, lo demás es más fácil, ¿ok? Por ejemplo, José is your subject, verb be ing. José is receiving the new workers tomorrow. There you go. Guys, tenemos 5 minutitos to complete the exercise. Si ya los tienen, los pueden ir escribiendo in the chat y así los vamos revisando también at the same time. So, 5 minutes. Unscramble the words. Si tienen dudas con alguna, let me know, please, para que lo podamos revisar. Yay! right. So, thanks, Giovanni, for sharing. Creería que es la número dos. I believe it is number two. That sounds okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, Brian, also did you get the same? Okay, very good. Yes, that sounds good.
Teacher.
Hello, Miss.
Perdón, voy a salir por acá para que no me oigan los perros. Es que quería pedirle que si después de la clase podemos platicar un par de minutos.
Sí, Miss, claro. Solo si me espera más o menos. Creo que ahora tengo sesión, solo déjeme confirmar.
Ah, bye. Solo, bueno, le voy a comentar ahorita si tiene tiempo mientras están.
Sí, o me escribe. That's totally fine.
Ah, bye. Le voy a escribir entonces.
Bye, sí, porque. Just in case. Okay, guys, so in the meantime, let me check it out. So number two, we said, was good already. So Mark is sending the letters the next week. All right. Number three, veo que algunos ya me escribieron. What is number three? So Jane is working on the report tonight. Jane is working on the report tonight. Yeah, that's very good. Thank you, guys. That was nice. Next one is number four with Walter. Walter is signing the checks today. Exactly. So, como va a firmar, ¿verdad? So, Walter is signing. I see also number five with Marina. Marina is organizing the presentation in the afternoon. Okay, that's all right. Very good job. And we are only missing Guillermo. So Guillermo is going to the bank tomorrow. Okay, very good job. Exactly. So your examples are super good. You know, grammatically talking, very easy to understand. So thanks a lot. Do you have any question with this, guys? Are we okay?
Sure. If I say I having a party on weekend, ¿es correcto decirlo así? I having party.
Yes. Yeah. But solamente si la intención es de seguridad, ¿verdad? So I am having a party. I am having a party this coming weekend. So podría ser así, I am having a party this coming weekend, or I am having a party next weekend. So, pero sí, la idea es perfect, this is super good. So I am having a party next weekend. Mm-hmm.
Yes. I am having a party the next weekend.
Mm-hmm. Next weekend, on the next weekend or on the next week. So, yes, that's all right. Su pregunta yes, tenía que ver con esto, no, or something personal.
Sí.
Okay. Oh, I thought that it was something different. Okay, sorry about that. Yes, but it's okay.
Si digo I will have a party next week. Estoy diciendo que voy a tener algo, una fiesta la otra semana. ¿O no lo debo usar?
No. De hecho, está diciendo algo bastante similar. Pero como les comentaba ayer, ¿verdad? Todo tiene que ver con la intención, you know, con la seguridad, con el nivel de certeza que usted tenga. So if you say, I will have a party next week, está bien. We understand. Pero will es como que me dice, quizás la tenga. So no estoy segura. Pero si me dice, I am having a party, usted ya tiene todo planeado. Yeah, you got everything ready. So, esa es la diferencia. Yes. That's the biggest difference. Yes. Thanks for the question. That's a very good question. Okay, everybody. So, listen up. Vamos a practicar un poquito. Like, how to talk about these activities entonces, all right? Como decimos que estamos hablando de cosas, activities, de las que estamos seguros, all right? Les voy a cambiar mi pantalla. Let me change this a little bit. Okay. Vamos a hablar de nuestros planes. So present continuous, pretty much, lo hablamos para. Había una palabra que estaba acá in the description que dice, we use present continuous to talk about arrangements. Esa es la palabra clave. Acuerdos, arreglos, actividades ya establecidas, arrangement. So, lo que vamos a hacer ahorita es como un arrangement, okay? So, cosas que ya no vamos a cambiar. So, I got a couple of questions for you, okay? And I want you to obviously practice them, okay? Listen to you. So, my first question is, what are you doing after this class? Okay? So, guys, what are you doing after this class? Algo de lo que están totalmente seguros que van a ir a hacer. So, what are you doing after this class?
Yes? I read one report.
Mm-hmm. So, you are writing a report. Va a ir a escribir un reporte. Okay, I am writing a report. ¿Qué más? What else?
I am watching.
I am going to the gas station.
Oh, you're going to the gas station? Alguien dijo, take a shower?
Full station, sorry. Yes, I need to ATM.
Oh, okay. So you're going to get some money. All right. So you're getting some money.
I am finished homework class Excel. Advanced Excel.
Okay. So I am. Y vamos a agregarle ING al siguiente. So one more time, Dani. I am. Lo dijo súper bien. Solo me le faltó.
I am finishing.
Yes, sería. Very good.
Okay, teacher,
I am finishing my exercises, my homework. Exactly. So, voy a tomar un baño. I am, como es el verbo take, pero yo no puedo decir I am take. No se puede. ¿Ya? Porque no tendría mucho sentido. Entonces, transformo el siguiente. I am taking a shower. Okay. I am cooking my dinner. So, what else? ¿Qué van a hacer, guys? What are you doing after this class?
I'm brushing my teeth.
So, you're brushing your teeth. All right. Oh, me too. I gotta brush my teeth. Okay. What else? Are you having dinner? ¿Alguien va a cenar? Is anybody having dinner after classes? Not really. Todos ya cenaron.
No, really.
Yes.
I am cooking.
Yes.
You're cooking.
I have dinner.
Yes. Yes. I am going to the update with Pat.
Ingrid, what are you doing?
I am going to update with Pat.
You are going to update
voy a actualizar la tarea de inglés.
Oh, the task. Okay, you're going to. Okay.
I'm homework. Going to update.
Yeah, task. You are completing the homework. Okay, so yeah, I am. You can say updating. Solo le agregamos el ing a update. I am updating my homework. I am updating my activities. That's all right. Mm-hmm. What about the rest, guys? What are you doing?
I am preparing my clothes.
Oh, tomorrow. You are preparing your clothes for tomorrow. Are you ironing?
Yes, I ironing my clothes.
Oh, very
tomorrow
nice.
Tomorrow I start to work.
Oh, are you on vacation?
Yes.
Wow, that's super nice. So 15 days.
Teacher, yes.
Yes, Natalie.
You know, veamos si formulo bien la pregunta.
Oh.
What I am doing after the class? Te estoy preguntando. ¿Qué voy a hacer después de la clase? Que usted me responda.
Auto preguntando.
A usted. Supóngase que usted me está diciendo lo que voy a hacer. Entonces usted me dijo pay attention at that class. What I doing after the class. Usted me va a dar la orden que tengo que hacer yo.
Oh, gotcha.
¿Entiendo?
Yes, I got you. So yeah, it's like es como una self question. Mm-hmm. A question to yourself. Exactly. Solamente, como ya no sería you, sino usted quiere saber lo que usted va a hacer, right? Como cuando viene y le pregunta a su jefe, okay, jefe, ¿qué es lo que yo tengo que hacer? ¿Cuáles son mis actividades, right? Entonces, obviamente, desaparece el are, porque yo no digo I are, nunca. Well, sí hay una excepción, pero no acá, okay. Entonces, yo necesito el verbo to be, el cual sería... Exactly. So what am I doing after the class? Okay. So what am I doing tomorrow? Okay. Como cuáles son mis actividades, mis obligaciones. What am I doing? Yes. This is why yo también puedo agregar acá different words. Okay. Y hacer preguntas no solo para ustedes, sino para su familia, your friends, your coworkers. For example, me interesa saber qué es lo que Elizabeth va a hacer al final de la clase, ¿ok? So, cambio totalmente la idea because it's not about me, sino yo quiero saber qué va a hacer Elizabeth. So, guys, what is Elizabeth doing after this class? So, ¿qué va a hacer después de la clase? Yeah, so, los que estuvieron con Elizabeth, guys, what is Elizabeth doing after the class? Les compartió lo que iba a hacer. Did she mention that?
I'm going to sleep.
Ay, qué genial. So exactly after the class, you're going to sleep.
Goodbye.
Okay. Goodbye. Thank you. That's
no debería decir she is sleeping after this class.
Exactly. Si le agregamos after the class, yes. She is sleeping after the class, pero por lo general la palabra sleeping no se usa tanto, you know, como ella va a irse a dormir, sino usamos ir a la cama. Okay, so you can say she is going to bed.
She's going
very
to bed.
Cool, very cool.
After the class, yes. So sleeping very es cool. Más como en este momento, ¿verdad? So, oh, my dog is sleeping, my cat is sleeping. Creo que mi hermana ya se durmió. My sister is sleeping right now. Okay, but it, como irse a dormir, lo usamos, lo más común que van a escuchar es esto. So she is going to bed. Or, okay, bye bye, me voy a la cama. Es como me voy a dormir. That's the way we use it. Mm-hmm. So she is going to bed after the class. So that's super nice. Good.
Okay,
so envy you. Yes, because I am going to bed at around 12. Like super late at night. Yes.
Okay. I am go to the washing clothes.
After the class.
Washing clothes.
You're washing your clothes after classes. Oh my God. Okay. Yo sé que algunos van a preparar el desayuno y el almuerzo también para los que llevan comida. So I know some of you are preparing breakfast, preparing lunch. Guys, yeah, ¿quién va a prepararlo? Are you preparing breakfast or lunch?
Me.
Brenda, Ingrid, okay.
Ana
Delmi.
I'm preparing my lunch. Ya, teacher, ya lo
tengo. ¿Ya lo tienes? You have it ready. Okay, guys, what about the rest? So, Daisy, are you preparing your dinner or your lunch? Miriam, what about you, girls?
I am going to iron my uniform.
Oh, you're ironing your uniform after classes?
Yes, after the reading my report.
Ah, okay, so reading. Or writing.
The first reading my report, the after the iron my uniform.
Okay, I see. But I got a question for you. Are you reading your report or are you writing the report?
Describir sería writing.
Oh, writing. Yes. So you are writing the report. Okay.
Writing.
Yes. So también hay otra palabra que me imagino ustedes trabajan con formatos, right? Y deben de completar algunos formatos. So, no es tanto describir, sino completar. So, hay una palabra que es filling out. So, fill out. I have to fill out the report or I have to fill out the form. Que es completar o rellenar. So, this word is also very useful. Fill out. De completar, de rellenar. Mm-hmm. So, yes. So, you are writing probably your report.
Que es mitad y mitad, teacher. Fill up.
Okay, I see. That's right. So, guys, vamos a hablar de cosas a futuro, okay? We are going to talk about activities that we gotta do in the future. Yes, miss? Yes, Natalie?
Perdón, antes de que continúe, feeling es feeling.
Déjeme ver, el spelling es filling out. Sí, fill out.
Fill out.
Por lo general se usan las dos juntas.
Eso se pronuncia igual que feeling,
de sentimiento.
Sí.
Hay una breve diferencia. There is a little bit of difference. Oh, guys, voy a hacer un pequeño comercial. I will make a little commercial because I think this is important. Hay dos formas de pronunciar la letra I en inglés. In Spanish, para nosotros es lo mismo. But in English, la letra I tiene dos pronunciaciones, ¿ok? So, lo voy a cambiar. I'm gonna change this. Hold on, give me one second. Okay. So, I need to change only this. All right. So, we got two different pronunciations. La primera, esta, se pronuncia con una I larga, larga, ¿ok? So, solamente listen to me and you can repeat. So, esa es una I. I, larga, súper larga.
I.
La otra no se puede alargar. Entonces, es una I. I, I. Son dos diferentes, ¿ok? En Spanish, a nosotros lo usamos de igual forma. So, esto se lee como leave. La I larga. Ok, pero esta es una I corta, live, 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 ¿ya? Yeah? So, suenan dos palabras bien diferentes. Now, everybody, repeat after me, leave.
Leave.
What time do you leave your house? ¿A qué hora te vas? ¿A qué hora sales de tu casa? What time do you leave your house? Ok.
What time do you live?
Now, ¿a dónde vives? Where do you live? Live, live. Where do you live?
Live. Okay. Live. Live.
Now, we got the same situation con estas dos palabras. Feel.
Feel.
Feel. Usted la puede alargar y es lo mismo. Feel. But esta siguiente palabra, you cannot do the same. Feel. 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 Yeah, es mucho más corta. Fill out. I have to fill out. Fill out.
Fill out.
Oh, I feel.
Feel.
Entonces, es la diferencia. Esta se puede feel, la puede alargar, feel, y esta no. Feel, fill out.
Feel.
hasta se escucha como una E, casi una E, you know? So, this is the difference with the pronunciation of these two words. So, esa es la diferencia, mis. Se parecen, but they are not the same. Mm-hmm. Son un poquito diferentes.
Es feel and feel. Feel, feel. No.
Esa es una I larga, feel.
Feel.
Esa es una feel. I cortísima.
Feel.
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 Live. Feel. Live. Feel. Feel. Super corta.
Feel. 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 No.
Un poquito más larga. Huh? So, feel. What do you feel?
Feel.
And this one is?
Feel.
Feel. I gotta feel out. Feel out. Feel out. So, es muchísimo más corta. Mm-hmm. But pretty much, yes, that's the difference between both. Okie dokie. Now, guys, I'm sorry for the commercial. Most likely, este viernes vamos a poder practicar un poquito más de pronunciation because tenemos la revisión de vocabulario and pronunciation as well. Now, in the meantime, let's practice a couple of questions about future activities. So, number one is, what are you doing after this class? Okay. Now, the other one that we are going to use is the following. That is, what are you doing next week? Okay, siempre hablamos de futuro, okay? Y vamos a agregar una más que es, what are you doing? What are you doing on vacation? Ayer la revisábamos, but today probablemente ya lo pensamos un poquito más and we got an idea how to do it. Guys, quiero que creemos una conversación. No solamente las preguntas, sino la conversación. That means, incluyendo el saludo, we gotta include greetings, you know, hello, good morning. So you can be a student A, you can be a student B, okay. Y es como, hello, René, hello, you know, Anna Delmi, hello, Sandra, hello, Giovanni, how are you today? Yeah, and the other person says, oh, I'm doing great. I am having a great day. And you, you know, y luego empezamos a hablar. Hey, what are you doing after this class? What are you doing today? Okay. Oh, and what about la próxima semana? So vamos a intentar crear una conversación ya real. No solamente la pregunta así directa, you know, sino algo que sea más soft y algo que podamos utilizar like in daily life. Si se fija, here ya estoy utilizando, oh, I am having a great day, okay? Pero yo también puedo decir, oh, yo estoy bien. So, oh, I am doing fine. So, like, hello, how are you doing? How are you doing? I'm doing fine. How about you? Okay. How about you? La palabra how about you es como, ¿y tú? Okay. ¿Y qué hay de ti? ¿Y tú? So, how about you? So, and then podemos incluir parte de esas preguntas. All right. The idea, guys, es ya hacerlo más soft. Okay. Y no solo la pregunta así directa. All right. So, you can take notes of the questions. Allow me just some seconds. Let me make the groups one more time. And
I'm doing fine, estoy bien.
I'm doing fine, yes. Como me está yendo bien, estoy bien. Mm-hmm. So I'm doing fine. I'm having a great day. Everything's good. Hay muchísimas formas de responder esa parte de how are you doing.
I'm fine.
Sí, permítame solo one second. Déjenme terminar acá los grupitos. Yes, hay muchas formas de responder. Normalmente yo solamente digo a veces como bien del libro, ¿verdad? How are you? I'm fine, thank you, and you? Pero es como bien bookish, ok? Es como bien de libro. Entonces hay muchas formas de responder y de preguntar. So, yo puedo responder, puedo preguntar, right? Hey, how are you? Pero es lo mismo si yo le digo, hey, how are you doing? How are you doing? es lo mismo, yo quiero saber cómo están. Y también, incluso, give me one second, el spelling acaso me va. También le puedo preguntar, hey, how is it going? How is it going, all right? So, todas ellas significan cómo estás, all right? Para variar un poquito y utilizar otras palabras. So, everybody, repitamos antes de irnos, please. Hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you doing?
Hello, how are you doing?
Es lo mismo, ¿cómo estás? Hello, how is it going?
Hello, how is it going?
How is it going? Exactly. And normally yo le puedo decir, I'm fine, thank you, and you, and it's okay. Pero yo también lo puedo variar. And I can say, I'm doing fine. Me está yendo bien. I'm doing fine. I'm doing, ¿qué otra palabra puedo usar, guys? I'm doing great. Me va genial, okay? Everything's good. So podemos variar and not to repeat the same thing. How about you? ¿Y tú qué tal? ¿Cómo estás? Okay. So, vamos, creamos una conversación súper cortita, all right? Al menos que incluyamos una pregunta de eso, sería genial. That would be awesome. Si pueden incluir los tres, that would be very, very nice. And then we come back y vamos a presentarles. Everybody, let's go. Let's go there. Uno, no, todos están listos, ok. Everybody go there.
Sí, yes.
Sí, yo me presento, hi.
Hi, ¿cómo le decimos? Ajá, what about you?
No, espérame. Lo escribimos, lo tratamos de mejor así hablarlo.
Como sea, ahí yo preferiría que mejor hablado, quizás.
Ajá.
Dale más.
Me entonces. Va. René empezó. Empieza René nuevamente.
Hi, Hannah Delmi, how are you today?
Hi, René. I'm fine.
And you? I'm fine. I'm great. I am great. Ahí tenemos que a otra así como preguntar.
No, pero ahí para que tomemos en cuenta los tres, participemos los tres, sería decir quizás como que le hago la pregunta yo a Ingrid. Hello Ingrid, how are you to do? How are you doing?
Very cool, very cool. Very cool. And you?
Fine, thank.
Yeah, but do you have any plan for vacation? ¿Tienes alguna actividad on vacation? Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ustedes me dicen, yo voy a ver al lado.
I have listened.
Ah, yeah. Y ahí nos extendemos.
Okay.
I have lived and visited the beach. I'll visit the family.
Y ahí te digo, tell me, what are you, what are you, ya las perdí.
What are you doing after this class?
Ajá, no,
René, what are you doing after this class?
I am preparing my clothes because it's tomorrow. I am starting to work again.
O sea, soy genial.
Ajá.
Para que
sea. Genial. Oh, espérate, no. Estoy. I am fine. Y como estoy en clases. Entonces, después Dani pregunta, ¿va? Como que va, como ya estoy en la situación de clase, o ya estamos en la situación de clases, para que nos pregunte qué vamos a hacer después de clase.
Ajá, es que ahí va. Digamos, yo. Así, es que ahí ya nos saludamos. Ahorita el que ahorita tiene que decir a alguien una pregunta. Pero después de que respondió Jesus, ¿cómo está él? ¿Va? Porque ahorita ya sabemos que está bien, no sé. And Jesus dijiste, va, no sé.
Sí, but lo que pasa es que yo te voy a contestar, hello, Danny, I am fine, I am in class. Ahí no solo agregarme vos la pregunta, what are you doing after this class?
Ah, va. Hello, how are you, co-workers? What are you doing after this class? Así.
Pero, ya me habías hecho la primera, que era, hi there, how are you doing? Te he contestado, hello, Danny, I'm fine. And in class.
Ah.
Ahí estuvo.
Ah, ya. Ya, entonces, primero, ajá, ya te entendí. Solo aquí tengo que agregar una línea.
Ajá, luego volvemos. No, y ahí me
pregunto. Volver y te pregunta a vos, de un solo. ¿Cómo se llama? Moisés. What are you doing after this class? Ajá.
Sí, ya me pregunta a mí directamente.
Ajá.
Hola, hola, pues digamos general. Sería así, hello, how are you, co-workers? What are you doing?
Hello, hey girls.
Hola, teacher.
Hola, miss.
We don't understand the to do.
Oh, you gotta create a conversation. Le muestro mi pantalla, let me show my screen one more time. So, vamos a crear una conversación con las preguntas que inicialmente les mostré. So, es como algo preparado, ¿verdad? Como desde el saludo hasta el final. Yeah, so I got, for example, Elizabeth here, got Daisy here, and you start like, hey, Elizabeth, nice to see you today. Yeah, or hi, Daisy. Like, hello. It is... Uy, qué raro me sale, permítame. Like, hello, it is nice to see you, for example. What are you doing after work? Yeah, and you say, oh, let's have a coffee, for example, o algo así. Entonces, es como de crear una conversación utilizando las preguntas que les compartí anteriormente.
Okay.
Yes. So try to communicate. Claribel está acá.
Sí.
Okay, no la he escuchado. I haven't heard. Okay, so intentemos crear una conversación. Es súper cortita, right? Entre las tres. Ah, hola, miss.
Okay. Es que ella nos está escribiendo ahorita en el chat.
Ah, no tiene audio, me imagino. Okay, thank you. No worries. That's okay. But yeah, in the meantime, girls, ustedes sí se pueden comunicar y ella, yo veo que está, okay, no se preocupen, miss. Yo veo que ella está súper activa en el chat, entonces nos podemos ayudar de esa forma, okay? Les veo en unos minutitos so para que puedan terminar.
Okay, I am fine.
Uh-huh.
I am fine, and you?
Yeah, and you, Mr. Brian.
Okay. Me too, I'm fine. Tell me, what are you doing after the class? ¿Qué harías after the class?
Um, the check platform.
O puedo decir, I am checking the website, como el sitio web de inglés corporativo. I am checking the website, the inglés corporativo. Website, creo que así se dice el sitio web.
Yes, that is correct. Website.
Okay. Hola, teacher.
Teacher, para decir tarea.
Homework.
Homework.
Yeah.
Work, como trabajar también.
Vamos a agregarle home al inicio. Homework. Homework. Okay. O también puede decir task. Es como una tarea ya más formal. Task.
Okay. Thank you.
Vale, empecemos nuevamente. Hello, Norberto. What do you do?
I am fine. And you, Mr. Brian?
Me too. I am fine. Tell me, what is...
Hi. Tell us about it. Empezaríamos como... Yo sería...
Okay, see you later.
Ajá, cabal. El A dice... Es como el que empieza, ¿verdad? Hello, good night, how are you?
I'm fine. What are you doing to the next week?
I have a meeting. I go on camping vacation.
Really? That's cool.
Yearly, one yearly, sometime.
¿Y eso qué quiere decir?
Como que una vez al año, a veces.
No, pero yo te pregunté qué vas a hacer en vacaciones.
Oh, sorry. I am going to the beach. I am going to the park. I am going to the cinema. Your family.
Okay, okay. Teacher, ya que está aquí, le vamos a hacer una pregunta.
Ask me the question.
¿Cómo sería they no, we are a question.
We have
a question.
Yes. Yes, no problem. Tell me, what's your question?
Thank you. Es que yo le decía a Sandra, I am doing sleep. Pero no sabemos si se le agrega el ING.
¿Cuál es la idea? ¿Qué es lo que quiere decir?
Y ella me estaba preguntando qué iba a hacer después de clases. Entonces yo le iba a decir que me iba a ir a dormir.
Ok, sí, podemos utilizar otra frase. Porque hay, como me estoy durmiendo o algo así, no es como muy común. Entonces se puede decir, I am going to bed. Eso en general, me voy a la cama. Es lo más común. I am going to bed. So after classes, as soon as I finish, I am going to bed. Me voy a acostar.
Ah, ok. No se puede decir entonces, I am going to sleep.
Ajá, se lo iba a preguntar yo.
Es que sí se puede. I mean, yeah, you can say that. Lo que sucede es que el sleeping es más común. Como que ahorita lo estoy haciendo,
como que
¿verdad?
Estoy dormida y no.
Ajá, entonces por eso se puede ser un poco confuso. So when you say I'm sleeping tomorrow more time. I mean, suena como un poquito raro. Entonces es mejor que usemos I am going to bed. I'm sorry?
I am going to bed. Entonces no aplica el sleeping, sino que solo sería...
Sí se puede. Yes, you can do it, you can do it. Pero normalmente, to be honest with you, se ha escuchado más común el I am going to bed. No tanto el sleeping.
Teníamos esa duda que para aplicarlo, ¿cómo sería si le íbamos a poner así? Porque no habíamos tomado en cuenta el I am going to bed.
Sí, es más común, I'm going to bed. Porque el sleeping es como que realmente usted cae, you know. So, terminando la clase, es como que... Y que el cerebro ya se le cierre. pero no pasa eso, sino que uno se acuesta y ahí se queda una su hora, you know. Por eso usamos mejor, I'm going to bed. Yes.
Y para decir de día libre, se puede decir day off.
Yes, day off. Voy a tener el día libre. I'm having a day off.
Okay. Thank you.
Teacher.
Yes, miss.
Vaya, pero si yo quiero decir I am watch the teacher, no puedo decir I am washing the teacher.
Yes, de hecho esa es la forma correcta. I am washing the dishes.
I am washing the dishes.
Los platos, ¿verdad? De dishes. Yes.
Yes.
Es la forma correcta. I am washing the dishes. Estoy lavando los trastes.
Ah, ok. Eso sí está bien.
Hay palabras que son como... Sí, no, pero está bien. Hay palabras que es como raro. Por ejemplo, voy a ir de compras. I am going shopping. Ambas tienen ing, pero es la forma correcta. So, voy a ir de compras. Voy a comprar. I'm going shopping.
I'm going shopping.
Yes. And okay. That's the correct way. Okay. Oh, no problem. Girls, nos vemos en un minutito. So I'll see you in a minute. Well, hello there. Well, Miss, parece que ya tiene el gatito. So you got the cat already.
Yes, Miss, I have my patient. If you want that I participate, I want be the first.
Awesome.
Because I
you got
have
to take care. Yes, I understand. Of course, that would be awesome. So, who is your partner? Marvin, right? You were working with Marvin. Okay.
Yes.
So, thank you, guys. Thanks a lot for volunteering. I think so you can be first.
Alguien que casi no hable nunca.
Well, actually, Natalie, she volunteered to be first. Así que that means Marvin as well. Así que gracias. Thanks a lot. So guys, vamos a escuchar a Marvin and Natalie, right? Help us with your conversation and we can check. No se preocupe por el perrito, miss. We understand. So it's okay.
Bye. Out.
Can you begin? Begin.
Sí, yo... No, o sea, yo estoy hablando y soy el perro.
Sí. No ladre, Marvin, hable.
Acaba. Hello, Natalie. Good night. How are you?
I'm fine, Marvin. What are you doing the next week?
I have a meeting to go on a camping vacation.
Really, that's good. I am working out of the city next week.
Ah, really? Where are you going?
I'm going to Cabañas to work.
Ah, okay. Hey, see you later. Nice to meet you. Bye bye.
Okay, see you later. Entonces, este.
Nice. Pues, that was quite good.
Espero que hayamos pronunciado bien.
No, de hecho no se escucha así como que tan fuerte, you know? So yes, I think we got it. That was very nice. So if that is true, good for you, you know, that you're going to Cabañas to work. Very good job. I like it a lot. Thank you. Thank you so much. All right.
Okay, thank you.
You're so welcome.
Pido permiso, teacher, para arreglar esto.
Yes, Miss, no worries. Take your time. It's okay. Thanks a lot. So thanks for joining as well. Marvin, so I leave it in your hands. Okay, lo dejo en sus manos. Who is next?
Alguien que casi no participe. Bueno, que no haya podido participar, más bien.
Who?
Desmedido. Oh, bueno. No, ya participa. ¿Qué tal? Jocelyn. Espera.
Jocelyn.
Oh, sí participa.
No, but it's okay. I mean, yeah, anybody, that's fine. So Jocelyn está con nosotros, right? Are you with us?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, cool. So your partner era Giovanni. Hey, Giovanni. Yeah. Nice. Okay, so go, guys. We listen to you.
Okay. Hello, Giovanni. How it is going?
Hello, Jocelyn. I am doing great.
Oh, it's okay?
Yeah.
Tell me, Giovanni, why are you going after the class?
I am taking a shower and I am ironing my clothes. And also I am finished my advanced Excel on homework.
Oh, super nice. Very good.
Jocelyn, another question.
Tell me, what are you going next week?
I am reading a book of 60 Shades of Grey. And I am going to the world weekly. I am going to the world weekly.
Okay. Me, I'm going to the park with my daughter and my husband. Tell me, you have a visit your family?
Oh yeah, I visit my family.
Yes.
Yes. I going to the beach, to the Tunco beach with my family. And you, Jocelyn, what are you doing on vacation?
I'm going to the beach and I'm going to clean my house, and I'm going to watch my movie.
Okay. Finished, teacher.
Awesome, guys. I love it. That was super good. Guys, let's give them some emojis. That was very good. So I like it. Me gustó mucho, like, the way you organize your ideas, you know? So bien coherentes, very good pronunciation, good intonation. That was very nice. I like it a lot. Suena super bien. That was very nice. Solo algunas pedacito se me les olvidó la parte de ing, you know, like I'm going, pero se va puliendo con el tiempo. But super nice job. Guys, tomorrow we continue con los que nos quedan pendientes, okay? So it's not just today, we will continue with this. But in the meantime, you know, I have to let you go because tengo one-on-one. Chicos, please, no se les olvide completar las actividades diarias que tenemos, de ser posible antes del día viernes para que ya se vayan el fin de semana tranquilamente, right? Si alguien puede terminar y avanzar la plataforma cuando tengan un par de minutos libres en su trabajo, do it, please. Porque si ya se quedan con esa tranquilidad de ya completé los exámenes, ya completé las actividades, and I'm good, okay? Ya estoy libre de la plataforma. So we can also do that, all right? Solo antes que nos vayamos, se me quedaron pendientes unos de asistencia. Regálenme un segundito, solamente reviso here para que no se me quede nadie como sin asistencia. So, give me one second.
Present.
Sí, yo creo que me hace falta Marvin.
Mi teacher.
Present.
Ahorita, deme un segundito, solo busco el documento to update it. And there we go. Okay, so I am missing Ana Delmi.
Here, teacher.
Thank you very much. I am missing Dani.
Tuve problemas al ingresar, teacher. Por eso entré tarde.
Sí, Miss, me imagino, porque usted la veo súper conectada bien tempranito. Pero gracias, gracias por estar con nosotros. Teacher. I am missing Giovanni. I am missing Marvin.
Present.
I gotcha. All right. Thank you so much. Okay, everybody. So, gracias por su tiempo. Thanks a lot for being here. Ingrid, creo que ya la había marcado. No se preocupe. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Have a good night.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye. Good night.
See you. Miss you guys.
See you.
See you, co-workers.